Today, I'll be providing a brief demonstration of NextLabs Entitlement Management for ServiceNow. NextLabs Entitlement Management for ServiceNow is a solution that enables organizations to granularly and dynamically protect data in ServiceNow based on attributes about users and the ServiceNow resources they are trying to access. NextLabs Entitlement Management for ServiceNow enables organizations to protect sensitive data from unauthorized access and comply with corporate or government compliance policies. The NextLabs solution for ServiceNow brings several benefits. First and foremost, we help secure your ServiceNow data. Second, we're able to enhance your business agility by enabling you to respond more quickly to changes in market conditions or government regulations. Third, NextLabs enables your organization to make compliance processes more efficient, streamlining monitoring, auditing, and reporting activities. And finally, NextLabs centralizes and automates many of an organization's compliance and security management tasks, resulting in lower costs of administration. This is a view into NextLabs Policy Studio. Policy Studio is a web application which allows its users to create and manage attribute-based access control policies, or ABAC policies, based on the extensible access control markup language standard, or XACML. NextLabs Policy Studio enhances the extensibility and usability of the XACML standard by providing an administration layer based on business language we call Active Control Policy Language, or ACPL. Using ACPL, new policy statements, policy types, contexts, and obligations can be easily configured by business users, as opposed to technical XACML experts. In the example in this slide, you can see a policy developed in NextLabs Policy Studio for the Entitlement Management for ServiceNow solution, leveraging subject, resource, and action components defined in the tool using ACPL. Let's jump into our demo. In use case number one, we demonstrate how NextLabs can control access to ServiceNow objects, such as incidents, for users with privileged access to ServiceNow. ServiceNow, as with any enterprise application, supports system administrators' need to have privileged access to manage the ServiceNow system to ensure it runs to the enterprise's specifications and business requirements. With role-based access control, or RBAC, in ServiceNow, users with the admin role not only have access to manage the configuration of ServiceNow, but they also are provided with access to create, view, edit, and delete any object in ServiceNow. But often, these system admins do not need access to the data inside of ServiceNow objects to do their jobs. And if sensitive information, such as classified data or personally identifiable information, or PII, is in a ServiceNow object, the users with the admin role can see it, posing a potential risk of exposure of that data, even though the admin may not need to see that data to do their job. Using NextLabs Entitlement Management for ServiceNow, we can control even a system administrator's access to the data inside of objects in ServiceNow. As you can see from this screenshot, the system administrator user has admin and security admin roles assigned to him. In a standard ServiceNow deployment, these roles would allow the user to view all incidents in ServiceNow. Using NextLabs Entitlement Management for ServiceNow, only users explicitly authorized to view incidents will be able to do so. In our demo, we have explicitly denied access to these incidents for the system administrator. So let's see what that looks like in ServiceNow. As you can see, we're logged into the ServiceNow console. We're logged in as the system administrator, and the system administrator has access to all functions inside of the ServiceNow system. I've saved a link to the Incident All view under Favorites, and if I select that link in order to view all incidents, the system administrator will be presented with the screen, but no records are displayed. The system administrator has been denied access to all incidents inside the ServiceNow system. And that's a demonstration of controlling access by privileged users in ServiceNow. In use case number two, we demonstrate control of access based on a user's title and location. In our example, vice presidents should have access to view all incidents unless they are located outside of the United States. In that case, any incidents classified as having ITAR data should not be viewable, even for a user who is a vice president. In an actual deployment, other attributes about the user, such as their citizenship or the country of incorporation for the company they work for, could be utilized in our policies. Also, exceptions may be made to a policy if, for instance, an export control license or ECN has been issued to authorize access to view ITAR incidents, that's International Trade in Arms Regulation incidents, by users who would otherwise be denied access. So this is an important use case for dynamic authorization. As new export control licenses are acquired and existing export control licenses expire all the time, it is very difficult to enforce authorization based on static roles when regulations and the information utilized to enforce those regulations dictate the need for authorization based on a set of constantly changing attributes. The first user in our demonstration for this use case is Jim Ranzetti, and as you can see, Jim has a title of vice president in the Department of Sales, and he's based in the USA. And based on this, Jim should be able to see incidents in the system, even if they are classified as controlled under a regulation such as ITAR. So let's see what Jim's experience looks like. So we can use the impersonate user function in our ServiceNow system to access the system as Jim and select the incident all view. As you can see, 60 incidents are being presented to Jim, including the top three here, which are classified as ITAR in the export control classification attribute. So these incidents have information in them that would be regulated under the ITAR regulation. And Jim, being a user in the US and a US citizen, is authorized to see these incidents. So let's take a look at another user, Brian Ravel. So Brian is a vice president, also in the sales department, but he's based in Italy. And without an export control license, he would not be authorized to view ITAR data. So let's take a look at what Brian's experience is like. We'll use the impersonate user function to switch over to Brian Ravel's profile and select the incident all view. And as you can see, only 57 incidents are being presented. The three incidents classified as ITAR under export control classification have been removed from his view of the system. The remaining 57 incidents all have an empty export control classification attribute. And that's our demo of enforcing compliance with export control regulations in ServiceNow. In use case number three, we enforce segregation of duties based on a user's department. In our scenario, compliance officers should be able to view incidents related to compliance functions. However, a compliance officer from the development department has no jurisdiction in the sales department, and vice versa. Thus, compliance officers should only be authorized to view incidents based on their scope of responsibility in the department in which they're assigned. So in our case, they should only have access to view the incidents that are created by users or callers from their own department, and they should be denied access to view incidents for callers in other departments. Again, this type of policy can be very dynamic, as users may move between departments or change roles regularly. ServiceNow customers want to provide access when it is needed, but need an automated way to remove or change access when attributes about users or incidents change. Using NextLabs Entitlement Management for ServiceNow, it is possible to define policies that will enforce access in real time based on the current value of attributes about users and objects, not based on static role assignments or stale data, which may end up out of date. So in our first scenario, we have our user Don Goodlife. Don is a compliance officer in the development department. Based on our policies, he should only be able to see incidents that are part of the compliance business service for you that are called in by users who are in the development department, the same department as Don. So let's take a look at ServiceNow and see what Don's experience is. So we'll go ahead and use the impersonate user function to switch over to Don's profile. We'll select the incident all view. And you can see that three incidents are available for Don to view. They all have assigned a business service of compliance, which he's able to view as a compliance officer. And the callers are all in the development department. There's Don, Jared, and Fred, all three users in the development department. Now let's take a look at a different user, Naomi Greenlee. So Naomi is also a compliance officer, and she should be able to see incidents that have a business service classification of compliance, but she's in the sales department. So she should only be seeing those incidents called by users who are also in the sales department. So let's take a look at Naomi's experience. Switch over to Naomi's profile, select the incident all view. And you can see that once again, three incidents are being presented. But the three incidents are different than the ones that Don was just looking at. They're still in the business service of compliance, but they're called in by different users. Two of them by Bud Richmond, one by Beth Anglin, both of these users in the same department as Naomi, which is the sales department. And that's our demo of enforcing segregation of duties in ServiceNow. Now let's look at our fourth and final use case. In use case number four, we demonstrate how access to sensitive incidents can be restricted by region or country and by security clearance. As stated previously, ServiceNow customers want to limit access to incidents by users based on the user's scope of responsibility. In this case, we want to limit IT managers to only viewing incidents for the region or country they have responsibility for. However, some of these incidents may contain classified information that requires an additional check to make sure the IT manager has the security clearance required to view the classified information. For example, an IT incident could contain sensitive information about a cyber threat or security breach. The incidents with this sensitive information are classified with an incident sensitivity level of top secret. NextLabs policy checks to make sure the user has a security clearance of top secret before allowing access to view incidents with a sensitivity level of top secret. An IT manager without the required security clearance will only be able to view incidents that are not classified with a top secret sensitivity level. The first user in our demonstration is Darren Merlin. And we can see by looking at Darren's profile that he is an IT manager in the IT department, so he should be able to view IT service incidents. His country is USA. His regional assignment is based on that, and therefore he should only be able to see IT incidents that are based in the USA, called in by US customers. And he also has a security clearance level of top secret, which means he should be able to view any incidents that have been classified as top secret. So let's take a look at ServiceNow and see what Darren's experience is like. We'll switch over to Darren's profile and select the incident all view. And the list of incidents is presented to Darren. As we can see, there are 36 total incidents that he can view. Looking at the location, we can see they are all for users that are based in the United States. And the top two we can see here have an incident sensitivity level of top secret. And he's only able to view these because Darren has a security clearance level of top secret. So let's take a look at a second user, Bernard Lavoie. So Bernard is also an IT manager in the IT department and based in the USA. So he should be able to see IT incidents for users in the USA. However, he has no security clearance level specified, and therefore he should not be able to view any incidents classified as top secret. So let's see what Bernard's experience is like in ServiceNow. We'll switch over to Bernard's profile. Select the incident all view. And we can see that there are only 34 incidents that are displayed for Bernard. We can see by looking at the location that they're all for users in the US. And we can see by looking at the incident sensitivity level field that none of them have an incident sensitivity level specified. So the two incidents that Darren was able to see that have top secret incident sensitivity level, those have been removed from the view for Bernard, who has no security clearance. So let's take a look at a third user, Kyle Lindauer. Kyle is also an IT manager in the IT department, but he's based in Germany. So he should be able to view IT incidents, but only call those called in by users that are based in Germany. And his security clearance level is empty, so he should not be able to view any incidents that have been classified as top secret. So let's take a look at Kyle's experience in ServiceNow. We'll switch over to Kyle's profile. He's listed here in the recent users list. We switch to his profile, select the incident all view, and we can see that only two incidents are displayed for Kyle. Looking at the location, we can see they're both for users that are based in Germany, and neither one of them has an incident sensitivity level specified. And that's our demonstration of dynamically controlling access to incidents based on regional assignment and security clearance. That completes our demonstration of NextLabs Entitlement Management for ServiceNow. Thank you for your time.